that, first mate?
Mutiny, Captain.
Again?
Mutiny!
Aye. Mutiny.
Hi, and Happy New Year. As you can tell, the weather is a bit, well, as it should be in January. So with that in mind, we made an extra long video with all the highlights from last year. So relax, get inside, make yourself comfortable, homey, get yourself warm, grab a drink, grab some biscuits, maybe some popcorn, hot dogs, whatever. Cold beer, Belgian beer, oh, whatever gets your buzz going, and enjoy the episodes.
Yay, yay.
Give you a quick update what's going to happen to this deck. So this stuff here is called tread muster, and as you can see, it's pretty worn. So what I'm gonna do is take this off and sand it so it kind of looks like this. At this stage, what I'm doing now looks like this. I got this awesome tool right here. So this is what I'm gonna do. Imagine that you think that we're just doing some tiny little repairs, touching stuff up and so, but in fact, this, getting that tread master off, is a pain in the butt. It takes about, well, 4 or 5 hours a day that we're actually working on it. This is the stage now, so we started at the bow here, where Lotte is grinding, sanding, sorry. And we worked our way up to here, midship. So we covered about 50% now.
Okay.
Okay. Poseidon, wij vragen uw zegen om Mutiny en zijn bemanning veilig op te nemen in uw koninkrijk, samen met de vier windrichtingen. En
ik wil graag een goede vaart in uw wateren,
ja.
Voor nu en voor.
Altijd.
Altijd.
In ruil voor ons eeuwigdurende respect.
Goed. We gaan deze fles oezo.
Oezo.
Ja!
Alright. Mutiny is gedoopt.
Yes!
Taste that water, baby! So small all of a sudden, huh?
man, I hit like a hammer. She's a cherry blossom, never was a critter. Tasting like a raindrop, she's gone for work. Heaven bring you back, cause heaven's got a number. When she's spinning me around, her kiss me as a collar. Loving is a wild dog, she's got the look. She's got the look. She's got the look. She's got the look. What in the world can make a brighter girl a temper? When anything I ever do, I do for you. And I go la 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 la.
Alright, so I just noticed that my spring line just snapped right in front of my eye. Luckily, I was in time to see it. So now I'm going to put this one on, and unfortunately for you, I can't film it. So hopefully I'll be back. Right, so it took me a couple of minutes. As you can see, I might as well swim for it.
So, this is my view from now on, instead of water and boats and sun, it's just grey. But the thing which is really, really nice is autumn, and I'll just show you now. There you go. This is what I really, really appreciate about being here.
Gas station, got some gas, filled it up, still wouldn't start, so took out the carburetor, and as you can see, it was very, very dirty, and with a kind help from Dave and John, cleaned out the carburetor with this tiny little hairpin, and I'm gonna put it back together and see what she says. After messing around for about 2 days on the generator, cleaning out the carburetor about 8 times in a row, I can do that blindly now, blindfolded, sorry, I finally got it running. So after much troubleshooting and stuff, eventually, long story short, I put the palm of my hand until the air intake, fired it up, got a compression, and as you can hear now, she's running.
Hi there! Well, there has been lots of changes since you saw me last time. As you probably can see and notice, I am, I'll give you a tour later, back home. I didn't even know the flight was still going, because they every minute or every hour they change the rules and regulations around Corona. So that was quite excited, but I made it back. I lost quite a bit of money, but yeah, you know, whatever, I'm back, that's the most important.
Hi, we have just set sail from Palos Key, just the two of us, which is great and first time experience, and we made it over to here. You see that? It's called Abeliki. It's on the island of Meganisi, which used to be a pirate island actually, until quite recent. And now it is again, as you can tell. But anyway, this is what it looks like. Just dropped anchor. And this is our stressful surrounding right now. There's absolutely no one here. It's for these little chapels, little house and all that.
Stopped and Roman almost got hit by the boom. So, so far the update. Oh, and Sticks puked. So far the update. Woo! I just grabbed myself on here.
Hold
there
on
we go. How are we, Captain Roman?
Bloody awesome.
Nice, huh? Lovely, lovely, lovely. There we go, our mizzen, the main, and the Jenny. On the lean, which you cannot really see on camera, but
see how fast we're doing.
I promise we are. And we're on the lean.
7.2 knots.
7.2 knots. This is so, look at that. Oh, you can't see it. It's 6.8 knots.
Oh,
7.1.
Yeah.
That's fast. Regular boats are 5.
It's not a regular boat.
No.
So like I said, we were in Nidri and it is pretty warm today. It's apparently touching 40 degrees Celsius. We lighten up, taking off our clothes and drinking cold beverages, and Styx does this. This is a sad part. Ghost boats. Well, not ghost boats, actually. Zombie boats. Look at that. Been here for years. Oh shit, what the hell is that? Oh, that's another boat. No, that's even another boat. Look at that. That's another sailboat. We'll cross this boat.
Those are 3 boats.
Fucking hell. What a waste.
Look. Hello, hello. So, you remember how we
just had a nice breeze in the sun.
Departure from Maleros.
Yeah, look at that.
A nice sun, no wind, nothing at all. Smooth sailing. And look at this behind us, like mortar, hell breaking loose.
Yeah.
Look at that. Oh, we got white horses. Lots of, let me just grab myself. Lots of wind. Look at that. All from nothing. Catching up on us. This was where we were sailing before. And now this, but you can hear me, the squall is catching up on us.
All right, on your marks, get set. Nope.
So?
The horse latitude.
Horse latitude. Doldrums.
Doldrums.
Tipota. Nothing. But look who we came across. Midnight blue.
Marcus was just dropped anchor. And had a great almost 6 an hour motor sail, 4.5 knots. And arrived here and it was totally worth it. Look at that. It's about, I think maybe 4 or 5 meters deep at the most. This is what it looks like now. It might seem crowded, but I'm sure it's more crowded without the corona stuff going on. And here's our anchor right now. Let's see if it's holding or not.
We are filling up our water tanks. It was quite difficult to sort it out, but we talked to one of the bars, cafes, where we always drink our beer, and the guy was very, very helpful, helpful. And we're just rowing up and down now. It's about 5,100 meters. So we're filling this one up. We're filling 10 plastic bottles up, and then we're rowing back and forth to the boat. We have around 260 liters of water, so I think we should row around six-ish times. Yeah.
Well, five to go.
Why not? We know what to do now. There we go. So it's a very nice workout, as you can see.
Thank you.
So we arrived at my boat, and I actually just woke up on it, and met some nice people yesterday, went for a few drinks and food. So, and this is the state of the boat you find it in. As you can see, we didn't make all this mess. It was, we're supposed to clean it up.
Right, we are entering the day three. Let me just show you. We are heading for Corsica, right here. This is where we left off, near Montpellier, and we're almost halfway. Just a while ago, a few minutes ago, I was trimming the sails and setting course, and the wind is just perfectly fine. It's almost on the beam. And I saw a dolphin just splash out, just 2 meters away from the boat, from midship, splash out and landed on his back. Of course, I didn't have a GoPro on me right now. This is the scenery I'm looking at right now. And as soon as that sun sets, I'm gonna get Bobby a shake and see it's starting to go. We'll have a nice glass of scotch. I'm gonna turn in, he's gonna take the helm. Quite speechless, actually. Right, so we arrived in a very, very nice pontoon.
Yeah, Bobby's got cleaned up. Look,
Bobby's got cleaned up. Look at this.
I can't hold my shirt, but
and trust me, it doesn't stink as much anymore.
Yeah.
And we got some great help from these guys, the mooring men.
Unbelievable.
And now we're enjoying a cup of wine and the view. The Italians just are coming in, like sheep in bikini. So we're just gonna lay back and
see what the camera finds.
And see, yeah, you know, the wildlife. Here we are making dinner. Some nice cod. And cutlery. Plates. A hungry cat. And a naked chick.
Hey!
Hey! Hey! Up!
Hey! Up!
Hey! Up!
Hey! Up!
Hey, up.
What are we gonna do?
What are we gonna do? Shh!
Yamas!
Yamas!
Tastes like more.
More? Hello lads and lasses, welcome to the western coast of Scotland.
Arr!
As you can tell, we saw bloody rainfall, and a minute ago there was land in sight,
but there is no one.
There's none now. So
welcome to sunny green.
Yeah, I want my money back.
Hello, beautiful peeps. Ah, very, very happy because I really like it up here. So the view is just amazing. Let me get in front of the mast.
So what we're doing now, what we have been doing a few hours now, and running back and forth the boat, getting supplies to clean up the boat. I flaked the entire anchor chain. Put the anchor down, and this is against rats, actually, to prevent rats from crawling up the anchor and ending up in the anchor locker, or worse. So, nothing yet.
Tipota.
No. Okay, well.
You guys gonna come another time?
Here.
Oh, wait, wait, rats.
Yeah.
Hey!
Bravo!
I've only 2 words to you. Marry me.
Pretty cool.
Guys, you rock.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm gonna cry.
Let's install this stuff. Hi guys, we just reached 2,000 viewers for one particular video. Can I have a cheers for sailing SV Mutiny? That's a goddamn camera. Right, so we started locating the problem. The first thing that we did is take the cover off, as you can see, and we noticed that there is a little grounding cable here, and I start pulling on it to see where it's attached to. When I started pulling on it, it just gave away, it just broke, so it's heavily corroded, as you can tell. It's just brittle.
Got it.
My yellow.
Look. Okay, bravo, sticks. Bravo, doctor.
Good boy.
Yeah. Oh, hey. Good boy, Rhea.
Yeah.
You okay, sticks?
Yeah, I'll give it. Druggy sticks. Hey, as high as a kite.
Which is quite a challenge, but it's good because we fill each other. We work in different ways, so we're a good combination. Luckily, and yeah, he knows certain things that I don't think of, and the other way around. So together we make one big hole. That's the romantic step now I'm saying this. So that's good.
Good news, that's good.
I'm happy. It's extremely satisfying to watch, you gotta tell you. It's a good show, this one is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How is it made?
Look at that.
How do you say it in English again?
I call it John in English.
Spring washer.
Shh. Spring washing. We got normal washers,
spring,
but these
washer
are a bit uneven, you see?
Yeah, split.
So it's like a spring.
Hello? So I am going for a shower. As you know, summer season ended, so it's winter and quite cold and windy. But it's time to wash my hair and take a shower. And as you can see, I do this face mask once a week, and I'm bright yellow.
Yeah, and here's the moment you all be waiting for. Lotte's gonna reveal her secret recipe of her face mask and shampoo, homemade. So what's cooking in the galley?
And I just washed it now, so as you can see, pretty cool.
It's the best, I'll tell you. It's got this loose little chickpea flour, but it will reveal itself at some point.
Yeah, I think after we met each other on a metal festival, and then after 6 months, I packed all my bags and I rang the door from Ramon's house, like, I'm here.
Yeah.
So
and we
from there
off.
On, yeah. We lived one more year in the Netherlands, and then we started traveling together for the next eight to nine years.
Just backpacking and to come back to the question, what you do while backpacking is you live in fairly confined spaces. You're not sharing any luxury at all. You're just sitting in buses, fucking 18 hours in a row, bumping up and down, getting sick, diarrhea,
yep, vomiting.
There's nothing romantic about it, trust me.
No.
So, but it's cool for us. So, because we're not the romantic type.
Really good.
Very good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Nice. Now, what all your viewers have been waiting for?
Me nosy.
Yeah.
Looking through the.
Let's be nosy.
Good. Secret enough.
Yep. This is the pilot house. The wheel house. What do you call it? The wheel house.
Pilot house. Wheel house.
Yeah. Captain's quarters. See who lives here.
See you. Who would live in a house like this?
Who would live in
it? It's very challenging.
And she likes boats.
That's important. Yeah.
In the summer, she's dark and mysterious. And in the winter, she's pale but very interesting.
Ooh. Oh my God, she's melting.
It's too early for this.
It's too early for this.
I don't know what the secret is. I told him you're very talented.
Don't you love that laugh? Eh?
We got it!
So, we got to say about that.
So, we got new stuff.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to know what we have, check out our next episode.
Or this one.
Yeah, sorry, got a bit distracted. We're looking at a couple of playing dolphins. It's too far to see for you, unfortunately, so you got to take a word for it.
Get back and home along with you.
Boy, I need help.
My girl, my girl, don't lie to me. Tell me, when did you sleep last night?
In the heart, in the heart.
Where? Where did you sleep?
There.
Nice and dark, nice and dark. I can see the moon. Yay!
Hi!
Hello!
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you feel like binge watching all the episodes, you can go to Full Mutiny playlist on our YouTube channel.
Yep.
And we'd like to thank our Patreons for their awesome support. Thank you very much, guys. Don't forget, it's never too late to be a Patreon as well.
Yeah.
So, with that, we wish you a very happy and prosperous
New Year.
Yeah. Stay safe.
Bye-bye.
Bye.